Roe was 16 years old when he ended up passing, but he came to us when he was around four. So he spent the last 12 years here working as a police horse, and a wonderful police horse at that. He was always a take-care-of-business horse, bold, beautiful, and big. He weighed 2,000 pounds. He was loved by everybody that worked here. He was what I would like to refer to as being a real gentle giant. Really a pleasure to work around. And when you were on his back, you felt like you owned things, okay? He just gave you that confidence. He was my G20 horse. And during the G20, you know, most police officers will tell you, yeah, they were a little uncomfortable, huge crowds and a little overwhelming. But being on Royal's back, it gave me that extra confidence. I knew we could handle it. And, you know, he's just a fantastic companion and partner. A horse that we also use for a lot of our training. When we bring in a young horse, usually they're around three or four. Some of them, you know, they've just left the farm and they're uncomfortable. We would often take Royal and have him walk on out of the barn with the brand new baby and teach him how it is to be a police horse. And of course, the baby would derive strength from Royal just because he was, you know, so confident and such a good horse. The memorial service is going to be happening on Tuesday. And honestly, I don't have all the pertinent details to give to you at this point, but I know that the members of the unit, we certainly are going to be paying our respects to the horse, because he was fantastic, and he's going to be missed.